वेलकम टू श्री दिगंबर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी दौसा। आई एम सदानंद पाराशर फ्रॉम सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। सदानंद, सब्जेक्ट डिज़ाइन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर, लेक्चर नंबर 22 एंड टॉपिक नेम एनालिसिस एंड डिज़ाइन ऑफ एक्सियली लोडेड शॉर्ट कॉलम्स। Tied and helically bound are the two type of column mentioned. These are two type of columns are taken up in this when they are short and subjected to axially loads. Out of several types of plan forms, only rectangular and square cross section are covered in this lesson. For the tied columns and circular cross section for the helically bound columns, axially loaded columns also need to be designed keeping the provision of resisting some moments, which normally is the situation in most of the practical columns. This is ensured by checking the minimum eccentricity of the column applied on these columns. Moreover, the design strength of concrete and steel are further reduces in the design of such columns. Further assumptions regarding the strengths of concrete and steel. All the assumptions required for the derivation of the governing equation are given. The stress and strain of mild steel and deformed bar are given in respectively in the previous lectures. The stress block of compressive part of concrete is given in which is used in the design of beam by limit state of collapse. The maximum design strength of concrete is shown as constant at 0.446 fck when the strain ranges 0.02 to 0.0035. The maximum design stress of steel is 0.8587 fy. This is the tension side and this is compression side. The short axially loaded columns shall be designed with a minimum eccentricity. Moreover, the design strength of concrete and steel are further reduced to 0.4 fck and 0.6 fy. 0.4 fck is for concrete and 0.67 fy for steel respectively. To take care of the minimum eccentricity of 0.005 times the lateral dimensions of stipulated in Indian Standard Code 456, it is noticed that there is no attempt at strain compatibility. Also, the phenomenon of creep has not been directly considered. So here EX minimum and EY minimum, here which is EX minimum is equal to और ग्रेटर ऑफ एल बाई 500 प्लस डी बाई 30 और 20 mm. सो विच इज ग्रेटर, विच वैल्यू वी टेक, एंड ऑल्सो फॉर ए वाई मिनिमम विच इज ग्रेटर ऑफ एल बाई 500 प्लस बी बाई 30 और 20 mm, विच वैल्यू इज ग्रेटर देन सेलेक्ट द मैक्सिमम वैल्यूज ऑफ एल ई एक्स अपॉन डी एंड एल ई वाई अपॉन बी शुड नॉट एक्सीड 12 इन शॉर्ट कॉलम विच इज द स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो. फॉर ए शॉर्ट कॉलम अनसपोर्टेड लेंथ एल विच इज इक्वल टू एल ई एक्स वी कैन अज्यूम एल इक्वल टू 12D और 12B वेन बी इज कंसिडर्ड. थस वी कैन राइट द मिनिमम इसेंट्रिसिटी इक्वल टू 12D बाई 500 प्लस डी बाई 30 इक्वल टू 0.057D विच हैज़ बीन टेकन एज 0.05D और 0.05B. विच वैल्यू वी टेक बी और डी अकॉर्डिंग टू द वैल्यू सेलेक्ट एज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ इसेंट्रिसिटी ऑफ ए शॉर्ट कॉलम. इट इज देयर फोर नेसेसरी टू कीप प्रोविजन शुड दैट द शॉर्ट कॉलम्स कैन रेसिस्ट द एक्सीडेंटल मोमेंट्स ड्यू टू द अलोएबल मिनिमम इसेंट्रिसिटी बाई द लोअरिंग द डिजाइन स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट बाई 10% फ्रॉम द वैल्यू ऑफ 0.446 FCK यूज फॉर द डिजाइन ऑफ फ्लेक्सरल मेंबर्स. थस वी हैव द डिजाइन स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट इन द डिजाइन ऑफ शॉर्ट कॉलम एज 0.9 × 0.446 FCK. देन वी हैव इक्वल टू 0.4 FCK. द रिडक्शन ऑफ द डिजाइन स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ स्टील एक्सप्लेन्ड. फॉर माइल्ड स्टील द डिजाइन स्ट्रेंथ एट विच द स्ट्रेन इज 0.002 इज FY डिवाइडेड बाय 1.15. हियर 1.15 इज फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी एंड इक्वल टू 0.87 FY. However, the design strength of deformed bars, which are Fe415 and Fe500, are obtained according to SP16 of Table A. The corresponding design strengths are obtained by making linear interpolation. These values of design strengths for which the strain is 0.002 are as follows. This is the values for Fe415 and Fe500 according to the interpolation formula, which is we have read in maths. When we select the value between the two values, we can use interpolation formula. And here we find the value of Fe415 and Fe500. We select interpolation formula. A further reduction in each of three values is made to take care of the minimum eccentricity as explained for the design strength of concrete. Thus, the acceptable design strength of steel for the three grades after reducing 10% from the above mentioned. So here we deduct the 10% from 0.87 FY. So here 0.78 FY, 0.71 FY, and 0.67 Fy. For Fe 250, Fe 415 and Fe 500 respectively. According to 0.67 Fy as the design strength for all grades of steel while designing the short columns, therefore the assumed design strength of concrete and steel are 0.4 Fck and 0.67 Fy respectively. Equation for short axially loaded tied column. Factored concentric load applied on short tied columns is resisted by concrete area, which is denoted by AC, which means area of concrete, and longitudinal steel R, ASC, which means area of steel of column effectively held by lateral ties at intervals. Assuming the design strength of concrete and steel are 0.4 Fck and 0.67 Fy respectively, so we can write Pu equal to 0.4 Fck into AC plus 0.67 Fy ASC. Here P equal to factored axial load on the member, Fck characteristic strength of the concrete, AC area of concrete, Fy characteristic strength of the compression reinforcement, and ASC equal to area of longitudinal reinforcement for column. The above equation given in Indian Standard Code 456 has two unknowns, AC and ASC, to be determined from one equation. The equation is recast in term of AZ. AZ means gross area, and gross area is equal to area of concrete plus area of steel, because in column only concrete and steel are. So gross area, in gross area we can calculate AC, area of concrete plus area of steel. So here we can find ASC equal to P upon P into AZ divided by 100, and AC equal to AZ 1 into 1 minus P upon 100. Accordingly, we can write Pu upon AZ equal to 0.4 Fck plus P upon 100 into 0.67 Fy minus 0.4 Fck. Equation can be used for direct computation of AZ when Pu, Fck and Fy are known by assuming P ranging from 0.8 to 4. Here P means percent of steel. In column, percent of steel is 0.8 to 4%, which means that in column minimum area of steel, minimum steel percent of steel is used 0.8, and maximum percent of steel is used 4%. As the minimum and maximum percent of longitudinal reinforcement. Equation also can be employed to determine AZ and P in a similar manner by assuming P. This method has been illustrated with numerical explanations and is designed as direct computation method. And equations for axially short axially loaded columns with helical tied, when we discuss about which is for rectangular column and this is for circular column. In circular column ties are helical, so here only one value it changes. Here we can multiply with 1.05. All other values are same. So here total load, ultimate load formula equal to 0.1.05, 0.4 FCK AC plus 0.67 FY ASC. In this portion only one changes. And other changes are, the second point determines the pitch of the helical reinforcement. Volume of helical reinforcement in one loop equal to pi into DC minus phi S into ASP, and volume of core equal to pi by DC square into P. Here DC equal to dia of the core and phi SP equal to diameter of the spiral reinforcement and ASP equal to area of cross section of spiral reinforcement and P equal to pitch of the spiral reinforcement. And this is the conditions to satisfy according to Indian standard 456-2000. And finally we give P less than or equal to 11.1 DC minus phi SP into ASP into FY divided by D square minus DC square into FCK. Thus equations are the governing equation to determine the diameter of column, pitch of spiral and area of longitudinal reinforcement. It is worth mentioning that the pitch P of the spiral reinforcement, if percentage from, automatically satisfy the stipulation of Indian standard called 456. However, the pitch here P equal to pitch. However, the pitch and diameter of the spiral reinforcement should also satisfy this condition. Here we discuss about one question. Problem 1. Design the reinforcement in column size of 400 mm into 600 mm subjected to axial load of 2000 kN under service dead load and live load. The column has unsupported length of 4 meter and effectively held in position and restrained against rotation in both end, and use M20 concrete and Fe415. In this question given here, L equal to L, unsupported length equal to 4 meter. We can also written as 4000 mm. Here B equal to width, which is 400 mm, and capital D equal to depth, which is 600 mm. So according to the conditions, effective held in position and restrained against rotation, the effective length is 2600 mm. So we have LEX divided by D equal to 2600 upon 600 equal to 4.33, which is less than 12, and LEY upon B equal to 2600 divided by 400 equal to 6.5, which is less than 12. So this is the conditions for short column or long column. So here this both the conditions less than 12, so we can say that this is the short column. Minimum eccentricity, for minimum eccentricity which is value of greater in L upon 500 plus D by 30 or 20 mm, which value is greater. So here L by 500 plus D by 30 is more, which value is 25.2 mm. So here maximum EX minimum value equal to 25.2 mm, and EY minimum value is LEY by 500 plus B by 30, value is below 20 mm. So here we take 20 mm. So 0.05D equal to 0.05D into 600 equal to 30 mm, which is greater than 2.5.2 mm, equal to AX minimum. So we take 20 mm. Hence the given in clause 39 of Indian Standard Code 456 is applicable for the design here. So here which is the formula for ultimate load of column, PU equal to 0.4 FCK AC plus 0.67 FY ASC. So here in the question given is total load, which is 3000 kilonewton. So here 3000 into 10 to the power 3 and equal to 0.4 FCK, grade of concrete is 25, AC equal to area of concrete, which is 400 into 600. Minus ASC plus 0.67, FY equal to 415 and ASC. So here in this equation we can carry one side ASC and all other values are other side, then we get ASC equal to 2238.39 mm². Provide 6 bars of 20 mm diameter and 2 bar of 60 mm diameter rods giving 2287 mm² and pitch year 0.953%. This is the percentage of steel, 0.953%, which is more than the minimum percent of, so 0.953. So this is the minimum reinforcement for column is 0.8%. So this is the value is greater than from minimum and less than 4%. So hence okay. Next, lateral ties. So the diameter of transfer reinforcement is determined from according to the Indian Standard Code. So not less than from this condition 5 by 4 and 6 mm. So phi is 20 mm, so 5 by 4 is equal to 5 mm and 6 mm. So here maximum value is 6 mm, so we take lateral ties equal to dia of lateral ties equal to 6 mm, and the pitch of lateral ties should not more than at the in three conditions, फर्स्ट इक्वल टू 400 mm, थर्ड इक्वल टू 300 mm एंड सेकेंड इक्वल टू 16 टाइम्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द डाया. सो वी टेक हियर 16 mm डाया एंड 16 टाइम्स सो 256. सो विच वैल्यू इज फ्रॉम थ्री वैल्यूज विच इज लेस देन वी टेक सेलेक्ट द वैल्यू. सो हियर वी सेलेक्ट द वैल्यू 256 mm. लेट अस पिच ऑफ लेटरल टाइज इक्वल टू 250 mm. द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एंड ट्रांसवर्स रेनफोर्समेंट ऑफ द कॉलम एज शोन इन फिगर. हियर वी फ्रॉम द टॉप हियर वी सेलेक्ट 2 बार ऑफ 20 mm, 4 बार बॉटम साइड 20 mm एंड 6 mm at the rate 250 center to center spacing. This is the formula, this is the figure we design according to the solving data. Thank you.